Hi, this is Today from Switzerland with another knife review, and today we're going to be doing a update or final full review of a Trevor Burger knife. And this knife I had now in my possession for a bit over a month, and I'm very, very pleased with how it actually turned out, the place that it found in the collection, and I will share that with you. We're also going to do some more in-depth stats and every dimension and everything we will talk about here in this video. If you want to get a little bit more first impressions and unboxing vibes and some more information for the store that I got it from and why I actually got the knife, please check out my unboxing and first impressions video that will be linked here in the top right corner. And if you have seen that, come back here and watch the full review. So we're talking, of course, about the Trevor Burger LEXK CFL. So the larger version of the two different sizes that they offer on their very, very popular and iconic EXK model. So there is the regular EXK and then there is the LEXK, which this one is. And we also have the absolutely gorgeous and very unique sheep's foot blade option. These knives are also available in a regular kind of spear point or drop point configuration. All of them feature a very nice and pretty aggressive hollow grind, and most of them also have this absolutely gorgeous hand drop setting. There are some stonewashed variants available, and this knife here is also available in a liner lock version. This, of course, being the CFL, is the contoured frame lock version of this, which is at the top range of the price range that you can get from Trevor Burger. There is also a flat scaled frame lock version available, and there are different tiers of liner lock models depending on the scales that you're getting. And there are also a bunch of different steels that Trevor Burger is working with, mostly N690, M390 and LMAX. And here we have actually the LMAX version. So let's take a look at the specs of this really, really nice Trevor Burger LEXK CFL. Before we do that, I just want to give a shout out to Fort Henry Custom Knives and Vincent Robert. That is the store that I actually got these knives from, because on a bunch of these South African makers, it's pretty hard to get it directly from the maker, which is my preferred way of getting custom knives, so I can have some input in the making of the knife and can talk a little bit with the maker. But a lot of these South African makers actually have long-standing relationships with custom knife resellers, like, for example, Fort Henry Custom Knives and Vincent Robert. And Vincent is a great guy to talk to, very forthcoming, was no problem doing international shipping here to Switzerland. And also the site and the selection is very interesting, and they get in new stuff pretty frequently. And also the prices are very reasonable for the high-end custom pieces that you see here. So I certainly would recommend to check out Fort Henry Custom Knives. You'll find a link to them as well as to the Instagram of Trevor Burger Knives, as well as to their website in the description below. So you can check out everything I'm saying here for yourself. So now let's do our size comparison and full specs on the LEXK CFL here. So we get an overall length of 7.64 inches or 19.4 centimeters on this knife, with a blade length of 3.34 inches or 8.4 centimeters of LMAX steel. And then we have a hand length of 4.38 inches or 11 centimeters on the handle. We have a full titanium handle with some very nice fine milling on it. We have a blue anodized titanium pivot color, a custom kind of tri-wing pivot there in the middle. All the hardware is T6 hardware right there. We have a also nicely finely milled and blue anodized 3D machined titanium pocket clip. Everything runs on captured bearings. And the steel, as I said before, is LMAX at a Rockwell hardness of 60 HRC. Weight wise, we're looking here at 106 grams or 3.74 ounces. So certainly in the ballpark for a knife of this size and scale. You can also see that there are no real lightning pockets on the inside of this frame. You can see it's pretty much full thickness all throughout. But of course, you've got the inlay here on the outside that will take a chunk out of the titanium. We also have a titanium blue anodized smaller kind of backspacer on here, and a stainless steel lock bar insert with over travel stop, and an absolutely amazing action. You can also see that you have a bit of hardening colors here on the jimping of the frame lock, so that is something you don't see that often on Nice. You can see it's a bit of a rainbowy color, and that certainly looks very nice and shows you just a little bit left over here from the heat treat. And I saw that on some older Hinderer knives in the past, but I actually kind of like how it looks here. So you can see in the crevices of that jimping, you have the heating colors looking pretty interesting there. So I haven't noticed that before, but now in the 4K video stream, I actually can see the different colors here in the inside of the jimping. So very interesting there. Of course, the elephant or the mammoth in the room is the inlay right here. And this is, of course, a mammoth inlay. You can also see that here on the certificate in the background. And it just looks absolutely gorgeous. I wish there was some part of inlay on the lock side, but of course there's not a lot of room there. But as it is done right here, you have a little bit of an extending inlay, so it's not flush. Looks really, really nice. Got some cutouts here for the body screws, and a lot of character in the mammoth. So really, really well done. And there are different kinds of mammoth. This looks more like a ivory bark kind of thing, because it's a little bit rougher, has some crevices and creases, and mammoth ivory can look a little bit more uniform, like we have it here on my Brad Zinker Urban Barlow. So mammoth can look quite a bit different depending on which part of the mammoth and the just individual mammoth that you actually get, but I certainly like the look of this really ancient piece of almost fossil, coupled together with the super modern CNC machined frame of this Trevor Burger LEXK. You can also see that here we have the Trevor Burger moniker on the frame right there, TEC. So really well done. So let's take a look at some size comparison. So we have the LEXK right there. Then we do our standard size comparison. We have the Shirogorov F95NL and then the Neon Zero. And we can see really close to the Neon Zero size, even a tiny bit smaller. So really in my wheelhouse for a primary carry in terms of overall size. If you take a look at thickness, we see that the Trevor Burger is a bit thicker there. In terms of cutting edge, we're actually quite close. And then we do our standard benchmark EDC blades. We have the Para 3 and the full-sized Benchmade Bug Out. And you can see really close in overall footprint to the Bug Out, but of course it's going to be quite a bit thicker in terms of blade stock as well as in the handle. But in terms of cutting edge, it's also going to be a tiny bit more. So really close in terms of overall size to a full-size Bug Out. So a great EDC size here on the larger version of the EXK. So I'm very happy that I in the end went with the larger one, because I debated getting the smaller EXK first. And a good thing to notice that you can know when you watch this video around the time that it actually airs, a model of this with a spear point blade shape is still available on Fort Henry Custom Knives. I will link directly to that knife if it's still available when I release this video. So if you like what you see here, please check out the Fort Henry Custom Knives website and get yourself a LEXK CFL with these gorgeous mammoth inlays. While we're on that subject, let's talk about price. So you can have an EXK in the liner lock or the frame lock version from around $500, and then it goes up over $1,000. Of course, this variant here is going to be more around $1,000 in terms of pricing, just because it is the larger frame lock version with lots of the contouring and milling, as well as the quite expensive mammoth inlay. So certainly an expensive full custom knife right there, but for what you're getting, I think it's not overpriced. I'm really a big fan of some mammoth inlays or mammoth scales. You can see I also opted for that on my gorgeous and fully dressed Brad Zinker Urban Barlow here, and I'm very happy how this turned out. Can also see absolutely gorgeous damasteel here. That would certainly also look great on the burger right there. One thing that I would change if I had commissioned this build would probably be I would have gone with a zirconium collar backspacer, and if possible also clip, to tie it together a little bit better, because I don't think that the blue anodized collar and the mammoth go together that well. But that is pretty much a signature thing of Trevor Burger, this blue anodized, steel blue anodized titanium parts. So I can see why they actually went with this version. If you take a look at some other size comparisons, more in the realm of front flippers, we have, for example, the infamous and very, very popular on the channel, Brad Zinker Urban Trapper Arc. And you can see size-wise, this is certainly a less substantial folder in comparison to the LEXK right there. But in terms of overall length, they are actually very close. And then I have probably the most popular custom front flipper available at the moment, the Gareth Bull Chamwari. This is a 3.3-inch version, so this is going to be very close in overall sizing. So very, very similar to a 3.3-inch Chamwari. Also in terms of thickness, blade stock is a bit thicker on the burger. But other than that, really, really close in terms of overall size. And then we have a last one, also South African. This is A squared A9 by Andre Thorburn and Andre de Villiers, and you can see, not Andre de Villiers, Andre van Heerden, and you can see this is also very close in size. So it's very, very nicely sized overall for a full-sized EDC piece, very close to all of these South African knives that I got in my collection. And I think the LEXK is probably the best size for most people if they're looking to have a full-sized EDC piece here from Trevor Burger. Overall, while I had this knife, I really was impressed with the action and the execution of the detent. I think from all of the front flippers that I have, this is, in terms of action, really, really close to perfection. It's a very, very defined detent, while not being overly strong on my Chamwari here. Because the flipper tab is so tiny and the jimping is so finely spaced out, sometimes I actually can struggle, when I haven't handled it for a long time, I can struggle to actually open it. So I think the detent and the execution of that small front flipper tab is really well executed on the, now that I'm saying I'm can't open it, but it's really well executed here on the burger, and the sound that this knife makes is just so nicely done. And it's just overall an absolutely gorgeous silhouette that this knife has. Very, very nice in terms of performance, super thin, full deep hollow grind. Just a very small amount of flat portion up there. Love the swedge. And just the grinds on this knife are so well executed. As you can see here, the diamond in the front, nice and functional, fine tip to get into packaging and things like that. So as an actual user, this blade shape is really, really nice. The size is great. In terms of weight, it feels a little bit heavier than some other knives of its size category, even though it's only 3.74 ounces. But in the pocket, it doesn't really bother me that much. And it's just an absolutely cool contrast having this ancient fossil-like mammoth piece in this very modern-looking CNC-machined South African front flipper. And I think a burger should be a part of a good South African front flipper collection. These knives are pretty iconic. There are a bunch of production versions available, for example, from Boeker Knives. And I actually had that one. But I think this custom burger is really something to behold, and I'm very happy that I actually have it in my collection. And a thing that I noticed in the unboxing, and still I'm not a big fan of, is that threading through of the show scale hardware, and no like female end or just some kind of another screw head on this side. This just looks a little bit cheap, a little bit unfinished, but there are a bunch of South African makers that do it like this. But that is just something I would love to see change. And as I said before, if I could change anything on this knife, it would be changing the blue anodized stuff to zirconium if possible. But other than that, I'm super happy with my purchase. I can see the value here in this more expensive burger, and absolutely in love with this blade shape. I saw another reviewer that had the Spearpoint blade shape, and he was actually able to Spidey flick the blade. I can do it also here, but it really takes a bit of practice, and it's certainly not my preferred way of opening this folder, but it is actually possible even with this blade shape. But it certainly is a dedicated front flipper, so very, very happy with this knife. Absolutely gorgeous. I hope I can give you a good look around this beautiful knife. And if you want to see some more pictures and stuff of this knife, please follow me on Instagram at 730_knife_reviews. If you have any questions, put them down in the comments below. And please subscribe to me here on YouTube. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day and goodbye.